Hello, welcome to Evansing Academy. We are discussing parabola and this is video lecture number part 6. I hope you have watched already part 1 to part 5 before watching part 6. We are discussing now the various type of parabola, how it can be framed, how equation can be generated, how equation can be formed after giving certain clues, certain circumstances, certain points, certain characteristics. So let me start with the questions. First question was the basic of parabola. Find the equation of parabola. Find the equation of parabola. Parabola whose axis is along x-axis, along x-axis, vertex is at origin, and focus is at 5, 0. Here, if you think that the parabola is something which has, this is a y-axis, x-axis, and this is a parabola like this, and this is 5, 0 is a focus. This is what given. We have to, this is a type. So this type of parabola is called y² = 4x, and therefore we can easily write here, because in place of a, focus is a0, in place of a there is a 5. So equation of parabola will be here, focus is a0, which is given 5, 0, that is 5, 0. So therefore a is equal to 5. And equation of parabola of this type is y² = 4x, and therefore putting the value of a, y² = 4 × 5 × x, that is y² is 20x. This is the equation of parabola. As per definition, then what should happen? The directrix must lie here. An equation of directrix must be equal to x + 5 = 0. If I move with the definition that P is any point, x1, y1 is any point, and this is the distance on directrix to the distance from focus, and they are same, then using that also we can do that. So method second, what is that? According to definition, if P be any point, x1, y1, be any point on parabola, and M be the foot of perpendicular from P to directrix, then and S be focus, parabola S is focus, then PS is equal to PM. This is what, and PS is obtained by under root x1 minus 5 whole square plus y1 minus 0 whole square, and PM is a length of perpendicular from point to the line. You know well what is the length of perpendicular from point to the line. If x1, y1 be any point, and this is a line ax plus by plus c equal to 0, then length of perpendicular can be obtained. Say this is P. P can is equal to what? ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by under root a² + b². So this is what the formula means, putting the value of x and y in place by the given points, and thereafter divide by under root x is coefficient of x whole square plus coefficient of y whole square. So on the basis of this, we can do that again. X1 plus 5 divided by under root 1 square, coefficient of y 0, 0 square. Using the same fact, we can have x squaring both the sides, x1 minus 5 whole square plus y1 square is equal to x1 plus 5 whole square after squaring. So if you square them, what will happen? This is x1 square, or I can write here y1 square is equal to x1 plus 5 whole square minus x1 minus 5 whole square. So using this fact, we will have x1 square plus 10x1 plus 25 minus x1 square minus 10x1 plus 25. This will cancel. 25, 25 will also cancel after changing the sign. Minus 10x and minus 10x would be minus 20x. So 20x1. And now locus of this is, therefore, now locus of px1 y1, just to give the variable nature, we will write y square equal to 20x. So this can be derived as per definition, but since it is already described about all the characteristics of the parabola, and we are able to understand that what will be the nature of parabola, so depending upon the basis of equations, we can put the value of a directly, and thereafter we can write the equations quickly. But not always this is applicable. You have to go with the basic definition if there is something else is given. So that is why I am discussing here this method. What is this method and how we can deal for each and every type of question. So let me write another question. I hope you got this. Here direct value can be put because this is what given here, and here we can derive by as per definition of the parabola, right? I hope you got this. Now, let me write another one. Find the equation of parabola. Parabola whose focus is at, find the equation of parabola whose focus is at, focus is at 2, 1 and directrix is x is equal to y. This is what one equation is. Here focus is neither on x axis nor on y axis. So what to do? But directrix is given. So according to definition, we can proceed here. Solution, we can proceed as per definition. We cannot do the first method. We cannot apply first method here. First method can be applied if and only if we are able to understand that whether the parabola is parallel to x-axis or parallel to x-axis, along parallel to x-axis or parallel to y-axis. Here, what to do is, we have to go with the definition. Let S be the focus. S21 is a focus, and PX1Y1 be any point on the parabola. Any point on the parabola. On the parabola. Right? PX1Y1 be any point on the parabola. Now, M be the foot of perpendicular drawn from point P to the directrix. Directrix y is equal to x, that is y minus x is equal to 0. Or x minus y is equal to 0. You may write anyway, x minus y is equal to 0. This is the equation of directrix. So, what we can write for this parabola and what will happen? So, as per definition, we can write here, as per definition, PS is equal to PL. PS is equal to PL. That will give you, like this is a focus, we don't know where is the focus. Focus is at 2, 1, and dielectric system of here, we don't know exactly what kind of dielectrics is like this and parabola. If I am writing exact pattern of this parabola, then y is equal to x is a line like this. Y is equal to this line is said, y is equal to x. And directrix edge, focus edge, because this is the directrix and focus edge 2, 1. 1, 1 is here, 2, 2 is here. Right now, this is our point, 1, 1, 2, 2. But 2, 1 is where? X is 2, y is 1 here. So this parabola is like this. This will be the nature of the parabola. And focus is lies here, axis will be certainly like there, you know. So this is the directrix and this is the focus. Parabola would be like this, somehow like this, you know. So we can have this idea that PS is equal to PL. P is any point, this is a focus, S, and this is AM is the foot of perpendicular. So PM is equal to PS. No need to draw this program. I am just here drawing this program to explain the exact characteristics of parabola and you will be able to understand it, right? So here what I am writing here, this is a line y is equal to x or x is equal to y, or you write x minus y is equal to 0. Same thing is the equation of line, and this is the focus. PS must be equal to PM. So length of perpendicular, first thing I have to write here, PS x1 y1. So what will be the PS? PS is under root x1 minus 2 whole square plus y1 minus 1 whole square. And what about PM? PM is length of perpendicular drawn from point to the line. So in place of x we will write x1, in place of right we will write y1, divided by under root coefficient of x square, under root coefficient of y square whole modulus. This is what the length of perpendicular from point to the line. Now, I have to make this equation. So, squaring this, squaring both the sides as usual. Once you will learn this all, no need to write this step directly. You may square and write all these things here. Nothing to hide about. X1 square minus 4x1 plus 4 plus y1 square minus 2y1 plus 1 is equal to, what is that? X1 square plus y1 square minus 2x1y1 divided by, this is 1 plus 1, 2, under root 2. After squaring, it will be 2. So that will come up here, 2x1 square plus 2y1 square minus 8x1 minus 4y1 plus 10, because 4 plus 1, 5, and 5 to ja 10, is equal to x1 square plus y1 square minus 2x1y1. Now, if all these terms will come this side, so 2x1 square minus x1 square will remain x1 square. 2y1 square minus y1 square will remain y1 square. This is minus 2x1y1 will come this side, 2x1y1 minus 8x1 minus 4y1 plus 10 is equal to 0. Now locus of px1y1 is, what is to mean by locus? Locus in place of x1y1, we will put x and y to give the variable nature of the equation, and therefore equation of parabola will come up like x square plus y square plus 2xy minus 8x minus 4y plus 10 is equal to 0. This is the equation of parabola. Equation of parabola. So parabola is not only x square is equal to 4ay or y square is equal to 4x. Parabola has a different dimension, and this type of equation also represents the parabola, because here not only even power of x, not only even power of y. So we cannot say that axis of parabola will be either along x-axis or along y-axis. Axis of parabola is something like this, and it is neither parallel to x-axis nor parallel to y-axis. So that is also a point to be noted here, because axis of parabola is not always along x-axis or along y-axis. It can be anywhere. Any line can be x-axis. Any type of parabola can happen. You need to understand and explain. Every time, axis depending upon the focus. And one thing you have to pick care of, that this is the vertex and this is the focus. This is the point of intersection of, this is the axis of parabola. Axis of parabola. And directrix. So this is for vertex edge midpoint only. Vertex edge midpoint of what? Focus and point of intersection of directrix and axis of parabola. So vertex can be anywhere, focus can be anywhere, axis of parabola can be anything, directrix can be anything. Depending upon the different circumstances, we can have an equation of parabola. One thing I would like to tell you, that in this case, we are the general equation of second degree came out, and the general equation of second degree will represent parabola if determinant delta is not equal to 0. And what is that delta? We have explained this, and let me express this, what will be happen. Once the general equation, thereafter we will come back to again this. Let me write this. A general equation of second degree, ax square plus by square plus 2hxy plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. A general equation of second degree. Second degree. This represents first a pair of a straight line. A pair of a straight line. Delta is equal to 0. What is this delta? Where delta is AHG, HG, BF, FC. This is, or it can be write as delta is equal to ABC plus 2FGH minus AF square minus BG square minus CH square. If this will be 0, then it will be a pair of a straight line. It will represent a second degree equation, will represent a pair of a straight line. This is already discussed in the pair of a straight line. Once I would like to tell you here again, once again. Right? And AHG, you may remember, A, it can be, remember, anyway, AHG, HG, BF and FC. Just to remember, although girls are beautiful, you may remember like all handsome girl having boyfriend go for cinema, like that. So, just to remember this, any rhythm, any magic, any lyrics can be made to memorize this. And here, just to remember, although girls are beautiful, we can't deny for it, but here we can write, you can memorize like this, all handsome girl having boyfriend go for cinema. So it is easy to remember. Second point is here. Second point, pair of a straight line, delta is equal to 0. If delta is not equal to 0, h is equal to 0, and g square plus f square minus c is greater than 0, then it represents a circle. Represent a circle. also for this h is equal to 0 and a is equal to b as well. That is also a condition that a is equal to b. Third is characteristics that if delta a is not equal to 0, h is not equal to 0, so what will happen? There are only two things. Either h square is equal to ab or h square is not equal to ab. If h square is equal to ab, then it represents what? It represents parabola. Parabola. You may see the last question where the equation was x square plus y square plus 2xy. So h is what? Coefficient of half of coefficient of xy. So h is 1, a is also 1, b was also 1. So h square and ab both are equal to 1. So h square is equal to ab. Last example what we have taken, you may verify this. So whenever h square is equal to ab, it will represent a parabola. Whenever if delta is not equal to 0 and h square is less than ab, then it represents ellipse, provided h is not equal to 0. This is understood. Now fifth condition is, if delta is not equal to 0, h is not equal to 0 and h square is greater than ab, then it represents hyperbola. So just by see that equation will be a second degree, it will be hyperbola or ellipse or parabola or circle or pair of straight line depending upon the following conditions. So you must remember all these conditions. A second degree equation can be pair of straight line, can be circle, can be parabola, can be hyperbola and can be ellipse as well. So just to memorize this, you have to keep in mind less than 0, suppose this is like E, so E is less than 0, ellipse, E is greater than 0 like hyperbola, E is equal to 1, this is a parabola. So here these are the conditions and you must memorize this. E is equal to 0, if h is equal to 0 then this will be 0, so this is a circle. So you may correlate this all, and to memorize this you will be able to understand whether this is a second degree equation, is a parabola or ellipse or hyperbola or even pair of a straight line or circle. Now moving to the next question. Find the equation of parabola whose focus is at 0,4 and directrix is 2x is equal to 0. Y is 2x plus 0 or 2x plus y is equal to 0. Although here in this question it is a 0,4 focus, that is all lie on y axis, but here it is not given that focus, because focus lies on y axis, so directrix is also y axis, axis of parabola is also y axis. We cannot consider like this. It is not given in the question. So focus may be lying here. Think like this. This is the x axis and y axis. Focus is at 0,4. We can't deny. Focus is at 0,4. This is say S. S is a focus. But directrix is 2xy is equal to minus 2x. Slope is negative. Y plus 2x is equal to 0. That is y is equal to minus 2x. Slope is negative and this is passing through origin. So line passing through origin, y is equal to 2x. Slope is slightly more than this, you know, and 45 degree. Okay. let me draw a line. This will be like, this is a line and this is a focus. This is a directrix, so parabola can have shape like this, right? And this is a focus and that can be directrix as well. So directrix can have equation like this and focus can be this, vertex can be this, because this is a directrix and this is the point of intersection. So one can write here that parabola is what? No need to draw this diagram, just we can go with the definition what we have learned and we will be able to analyze this. This is a figure what we can draw. Focus is at 0,4, directrix is like this, this is the line. What this line is? 2x plus y is equal to 0, or y plus 2x is equal to 0. This is the line. If I took again, as per definition, anywhere point, suppose P, x1, y1 be any point on the parabola, then this distance and this distance must be equal, right? PS must be equal to PN. Using the same fact, we can calculate. Since PS is equal to PN, right? Therefore, PS square is equal to PN square, right? And now we can write x1 minus 0 whole square plus y1 minus 4 whole square is equal to PM, that is 2x1 plus y1 upon under root 2 square, because we have made a square now. So under root 2 square plus 1 square whole square, because PM is this whole square. So what will happen by using this fact? We will use it and write it like this: x1 square plus y1 square minus 8xy1 plus 16 is equal to 4x1 square plus y1 square plus 4x1y1 divided by 5. 2 square is 4, 1 square is 1, so 4 plus 1 is 5. Now, using the same fact, we will write here 5x1 square plus 5y1 square minus 40y1 plus 18 is equal to 4x1 square plus y1 square plus 4x1y1. If I use this all, 4x1 square minus this side is will come, and what will remain? x1 square plus 4y1 square, that would be minus 4x1y1 minus 40y1 plus 80 is equal to 0. And now locus of px1y1 is what? In place of x and y, x1 and y1, we will put x and y. 4y square minus 4x1xy minus 40y plus 80 is equal to 0. This is the equation of parabola. You can judge here. What is a here? You can just verify what we learned in the last session. And what is that? In this one, a is equal to 1. A is what? Coefficient of x square. B is what? Coefficient of y square, that is 4. And h is what? Half of coefficient of xy, that is minus 2. If you make h square, that is minus 2 square is 4. And what is ab? 1 into 4 is 4. So h square is equal to ab. That represents that this is a parabola, and I hope you got it, right? So this is the type of different conditions can be given. We will discuss some more question in the upcoming videos, right? And I hope you got this, you understand it. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. God bless.